What can you do to command that respect? How are you going to place yourself to get that respect automatically from your prospective in-laws? This one is for the wifeies. Igolando, hey, are you ready? Ogadi popo. My name is Eberechi Kaze. And I live in the United Kingdom. Should we scrap that or should we continue? Let's just flow as the spirit leads. So this is the woke issues here. Let me dissect issues bothering men and women of our present generations. And the whole idea is to empower, to uplift, share values, and give ourselves some awareness to help you enjoy this life better. That's why we have social media. This is the best thing to be alive. How to command. You see the way I said it? How to command respect from your in-laws. Now, all over social media in this present day, it's issue we keep hearing complaints of how, you know, ladies feel subjugated, if that's the right word, when ladies feel submerged in the marriage they find themselves. Ladies feel like they are the rock bottom, especially relationship leading to marriage, where they're not respected, nobody regards them, they're not valued. So social media now is where everybody comes and vent and complain and type, cry out what's going on behind the scenes in their homes, ranging from my mother-in-law does not respect me, my husband's siblings don't want to see me with their eyes and stuff. What is the way forward? How do you present yourself? Is it about you or is it about them? That's a whole topic on its own. But let us talk about our own angle as women here. Yeah? What can you do to command that respect? How are you going to place yourself to get that respect automatically from your prospective in-laws? Number one point is to stay in your lane. Should I increase the volume? Stay your damn self in your lane. Don't be in everybody's business. Don't be all up in everybody's eyes. Don't be trying to please every Tom, Dick, and Harry. Don't be pleasing everybody and their mamas and their neighbors and their papa. Look, no. Remember, you are somebody's daughter, you're somebody's sister, you're somebody's child. You are coming from somewhere. Don't lose touch of that. Do not forget yourself. The fact that you're going into someone else's family does not mean you are homeless, does not mean you've been chased away, does not make you an outcast. So you're not going out there trying to seek validation. You're not going out there as a roof over your head, as a homeless person. No, you are coming to contribute to another family. You are coming to be an addition to some other people. You're coming with your good guts. You're coming with you and more. You're coming with a whole you. Do you understand that part? A whole you. So, you don't have to be in everybody's business. Stay in your lane. On top of that, be respectful and firm. Be objective. You don't have to be arrogant to stay in your lane. No? Let it be that what anybody's going to have against you is, she's always minding her business. She does not even call people on the phone. She does not do this. It's better than, oh, she's rude. Oh, did you hear what she said last time? Oh my goodness. You know what I mean? You're respectful. Oh yeah, mama, papa, auntie, uncle, hope you are fine if you want to roll that way. Or sis, or sir. You get what I mean? Use formal languages. If you're the type who knows how to go mommy and daddy, that's fine. If you're not the type who knows how to use mommy and daddy, ma, sir, that's fine. Be very respectful. It's key. Nobody's going to come up and say you are disrespectful. It's dirty. Like, nah, it's a stain on your personality. Right? Stay in your lane. Respect yourself. Don't be where you are not called. Don't be, oh yeah, before they even say Jack, you're doing 100 things at the same time. It's not necessary, my sister. Don't go and kill yourself. Don't go and start what you cannot finish. You know what I'm saying? If you know that you know how to do plenty, okay, go ahead and do plenty. Maybe it's your own value. But if you know you have your hand is a lack my AK, like you cannot come and go and kill yourself, please do what is necessary and stay in your lane. Next point, keep your business to yourself. I mean, your personal business, business between you and your spouse, who happens to be their son, keep it to yourself. If you're the kind of person that if anything happens within your home, you've picked up your phone and you're, hello mommy, or hello auntie, or hello sister, hello uncle, do you know that my husband, this is and says, do you know that my husband, hey, you should come and advise him, do you know that this is what we are doing tomorrow, we are going to, everything happened in your home, you're trying to do, wife that can relate, and then 247, you're calling every Tom and Dick, Tom, Dick and Harry, with telling them what's happening in your home. Let me tell you, that is an avenue for them to begin to bring unsolicited advice. When you want it, when you don't want it. Yeah, because how is it that they're going to give you their advice or give you their opinion even when you do not ask for it and you want to reject it? But when they're minding their business, you're calling them on the phone and telling them, complaining to them that this person has done this one, that person has done that. So be ready for everything. So when you take your business, manage your business between yourself and your spouse, they're outsiders. Take it or leave it. They don't know what's happening in your home. Nobody can interfere. They just see you guys. Let me even say, they just see you guys outside and they're like, oh, okay. They don't even know what's going on. They're just like strangers. Oh, yeah, hi. We're good. Oh, yes, we're fine. Thank you. That's it. Let's even say people were even quarreling in your house, eh? And somebody knocks on the door or somebody calls on the phone. You'll pretend, oh, yeah, how is your husband? It's fine. Oh, how is your wife? Oh, yeah, fine. Oh, yeah, everything is good. Once you drop the phone, bam, you. Back to where we stopped. You continue your query from there. That's how it's done. This is my own advice. This is my own advice. I've said that's how it's done. This is my own advice. That's how to go about it. To get your respect. Because the way you talk, people read you and rate you from what you say. If you're the person who's constantly complaining, because believe you me, when you get into a relationship, especially a marital one, there's going to be a whole lot to complain about. From the way the spouse is careless, from the way things are done, you know, in a way you're not used to, in a because remember, this is someone who's coming from a different home. You're coming from a different home, different background, different upbringing, different family values. So you guys expect that there will be fracas. So do not come and be telling everybody, especially their own people, this is what my person has done. You just come and advise him. No, I see African grown women back in our home country are like that. They think that anything that happens, let me call his mother and explain. Let me call her his sister and complain. Mm-mm. That is how they too, when you do not call them, they will come and interfere. So give yourself some respect. Let people not hear your words. Let people not read you from the kind of things you say. Because at the end of the day, they'll be like, it's not that one that is always calling us and complaining. Give yourself some respect. Stay in your lane. Keep your business to yourself. Another is have values, as I said. Have something doing for yourself. When I mean have something doing for yourself, I don't mean you should be the most career woman out there. You don't have to be. But whatever it is, wherever it is you find yourself at the time, make sure you're very busy. If you're a full-time house mom or full-time housewife, full-time house mom, make sure you're doing it to the maximum. Make sure you're devoting that. Make sure there are no loopholes. Make sure there are no see-throughs. Seal it up. Your children should represent your full-time job. What do I mean by this? When your kids come out, it should show that yes, this woman is busy she's busy here. When people come to your house, they should see that, oh yes, somebody is working in this place. Make your job, whatever it is you are doing as a woman, an embodiment of your value. Let it shine through. I say to myself that my house tells you the kind of person I am. The kind of things I have, the way I put myself, the things around me, tells you the kind of person I am. Don't let these in-laws come to your house and then they have to be the one to notice how untidy things are, how unput together you are, like never to be caught on fresh, if you get what I mean. Let them not be the one to see your loopholes, because you cannot command respect that way. You cannot command respect when you're not even put together. it's going to give people the avenue to come and give you unsolicited opinion. Come and tell you that, oh, how about, it looks like you're struggling. How about you do it this way? Okay, how about, do you need help? Should we come and sweep your house for you? Should we come and, you know, all those unnecessary things. But when you own your thing, own your shit, right? Whatever it is you're doing, make sure you're doing it well, whichever it is. Whether you have a job, you're a career woman, make sure you're top. Make sure you're hitting it. You're hitting those milestones. You're doing it big. They will see you for who you are, see you for the much you're doing, and respect you for those things. Something else, be firm. Have your values. Know your principles. Know what you stand for. Don't bend for people. No. If this is who you are, if you're not... Okay, I give you an example. I'm the kind of person, let me explain myself. For example, I'm someone who is available if you need me for anything. If you want me to assist you with such and such, I will do my best to make sure I come through for you. If I check the situation of things and know that I'm in position to do this for you, and I definitely can, it's something I can do, I'm definitely gonna go all out and do it for you. But when it comes to like calling, generally I'm not the calling type. I'm not the type who's gonna pick up my phone and then be looking for who to call. Oh, hello sister this, or auntie that, or uncle this. Start calling everybody, you know, around the world. Start making world conference call. It's not my thing, it's not my person. And that doesn't mean I don't care. No, that doesn't, you know, certain people could interpret that as care, but think about the times when there was no phone. Does it mean people don't care? Does that quantify our feeling? The amount of times you call people, does that quantify? What does that even mean? Do you understand what I mean? Right, so somebody could still care for you, someone could still love you. My parents, for example, I don't call them 24/7. Whatever obligation I have towards them, at around the time I reach out to them and I pay my dues. Do you get what I mean? I check up on them when I have to. Most times, to be honest, they are the ones who check up on me, and then I reciprocate. I'm like, oh, mommy, thanks for calling. Hope you all are doing well. Oh, my sis, hope you're doing well. Blah, blah, blah. I try to catch up more like it. I'm more like catch up, right? 100% I care, 100% I love, but I might not be the person who's gonna always be the one to reach out. But trust me, when you reach out to me for whatever it is, best bet I'm your girl. Where am I going to? As a woman, you wouldn't get into a family, for example, and you're not the type who's always, oh yeah, how are you doing, calling on the phone, blah 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 blah. You're naturally not that type, but because you're trying to impress people, you begin to do it. You know what's gonna happen? At the end of the day, that's not sustainable, because that's not who you are. At some point, you're gonna give up, or at some point, you're gonna slack back. And what will people come back to say? Oh yeah, because they've married them. Or, oh yeah, because she has given birth to children. Or because, oh yeah, she has not come into the home. Or she has not become proud. Or they now have money. That is why she's not showing her real color. Oh. Do you understand? You wouldn't fault them, because that was how you started, and all of a sudden you stopped. That's it. So who are you gonna begin to explain to that? Oh, that actually wasn't who I was. I was trying to be a good person. Nah, you're a good person regardless. You don't have to do this and that XYZ to prove that you're a good person. Hence, you're not rude, you're not insulting nobody, respecting yourself, staying in your lane, keeping your business, you know, keeping your business to yourself, be responsive when you're needed. That is the much you should do as a wife. Nothing much. That way you have your respect intact. Nobody's gonna, that see finish will not come in. And do you know that it's from too much communication, too much how far, hello. Now, dear gossip, did they enter? Ah, do you know that so-and-so person said this yesterday? Do you know that so-and-so person wife yesterday? Can you imagine what she said to me the last night? Ah, do you know what? Do you know she's the one who even told me this? Now, so did they enter. So, to cap it all, to command and earn that respect from your in-laws, as I said before, is make sure you're staying in your lane. Make sure you're respectful, make sure you're firm, make sure you know your values and you stand by your values. Do not bend unnecessarily for people. This is what you do, this is what you stand for. State it clear, regardless who it is, no matter whose ass is God. How is it said? Okay, stay in your firm lane, mind your business, show up when you're needed. Don't be in everybody's business, don't be trying to kiss unnecessary asses. Remain firm, do what you have to do, and you will naturally gain that respect. That's how it is. Don't lose touch of the fact that you are coming from somewhere. You're someone's mother, before you become mother, you're somebody's child, somebody's sister, you have a family, you're coming from somewhere. You're not some homeless person looking for, or a headless chicken looking for where to hide, okay? You're not here to seek a shelter over your head. You're not homeless, you're not hopeless, you're not useless. You get what I mean? You have your values. So you're only coming, as I said, to contribute. You're coming with your whole self to add value. Remember that. I'll see you in the next one.